Hey guys, welcome to the Level 3 strategy video for integration. I'm Mackenzie.
I'm Hattie.
And in this standard, you are going to be expected to integrate a bunch of different kinds of functions. Now, this includes polynomials, rational expressions, which include a polynomial as your numerator and your denominator, exponentials, but only with base e, and lastly, trigonometric functions.
Cool, once you've got a handle on all these different types of functions, the next thing to go through are all the techniques that you're going to need to use. Now, learning to actually use these is half the battle, but the hard part is actually figuring out when to use them. The techniques you'll be using are indefinite and definite integration, reverse chain rule, applying trig functions, rates of change, numerical integration, and integration of separable first and second order differential equations. We'd recommend practicing these in isolation first to get a grip on them, and then looking through past papers to figure out how to recognize when to use each one.
The exam is split into three sections, and for your achieved and low merit kind of questions, you're just going to have to use your table of integrals, which can be found on your formula sheet. Now, the kinds of questions that you can be asked from this involve trigonometric functions, rational expressions to simplify, integrals involving a negative or fractional exponents, visual area problems, simple differentiation questions, numerical integrations using just the formula, and lastly, simple polynomials to a power using substitution as opposed to expansion to solve.
The harder merit questions will usually involve a trickier integration, so maybe an integration by substitution, sometimes even a trig substitution. They might give you the area under a curve and give you an unknown constant in the equation which you need to work backwards and find, or they might ask you to find the area between two curves. These questions are looking for you to show that you understand the relationship between an area and an integral, and also that you can apply advanced integration techniques. The excellence questions are more likely to give you an unfamiliar equation that you need to apply. Now, these look really intimidating, but it's just about correctly interpreting and using this new equation. There's also likely to be a question about exponential growth and decay curves, so things like Newton's law of cooling, population growth, or inflation.
Some strategies for success in this standard is to understand that every now and then you are going to come across a question that you're not 100% familiar with. Do what you can with it, and for some merit questions, even just getting the integral will get you partial points, so bear this in mind. Also, if you get a question wrong or you're not 100% confident with your answer, don't cross it out unless you've gone back to do some reworking and you've got a new result. If you put something down on the page that you're not 100% confident with, it doesn't matter because you're not going to be deducted points.
It's also really important that you use good notation throughout, so things like using square brackets for integrals. In general, good working is really important, things like lining up your equal signs. They might sound really boring, but the markers are looking for a clear train of thought, so it's really important that the way you structure your answers reflects this.
The key for studying to the standard is practicing a lot of different types of questions. In particular, you should be targeting the kinds of techniques that you're least confident with. And when you're practicing your questions, don't be afraid to make mistakes. And if you get an answer wrong, don't immediately flick to the answers. Instead, try to work backwards if you can, or try a different kind of technique.
Another important thing to remember is that maths is cumulative. So if you're struggling with something like negative exponents, fractional exponents, or rational expressions, good idea is to go back to the Level 2 algebra paper. All those skills were included for a reason. Another technique is to simplify or change whatever you're given if it looks complicated into something that you know you can integrate. So if it's a fraction, try to simplify it. If it's a polynomial or to the power of something, you know you can't directly integrate that, so you need to substitute. If it's a fraction where it's one polynomial divided by another polynomial, you should be looking to use substitution again. And if it's a function inside another function, you should use reverse chain rule. You kind of get the idea. A good study technique is to go through an exam and see how many questions you can immediately do, so without even having to think about what technique you do. Try and do all these questions in about 30 minutes and then go through and mark your work. Then, more importantly, go through all the questions that you didn't recognize the technique for, along with the marking schedule, and ask yourself how you would recognize when to use that technique. To test yourself on this, you can also go through a paper and just quickly write down what technique you'd use next to each question. Now, keep practicing.
So this has been our Level 3 Calculus Strategy video for integration.
We've covered a lot, but we haven't covered everything. We'd recommend checking out the past 3 or 4 years of exam papers to get a feel for what to expect, and also looking at the StudyTime walkthrough guides, which are available for free online or to purchase in print with next day delivery, and they're designed to walk you through all the content you need to ace this exam.
Thanks for watching, guys.